And a basic operation of Power Board simulation. So first step, you will go to new case. So take note that all drawing, you will go to network, okay? If you will go for drawing, you will proceed always to, you will focus always to the network. And if you will looking for your data, you are always looking for your field. What I mean? What does it mean? Your report is always, the data needed in your report is always looking from your field, and then the drawing always in the network. So first step, it is the new case. Then draw, then go to network, and then bus. How many bus that we are using? Okay, so this is bus one. Okay, so click. Okay, so we have now the bus number one. So since this is our bus number one, you can make it bigger like this, so that immediately you can identify that this is bus number one. Okay, and then click network again for bus number two. So this is our bus number two. Click OK, then you will make it these two as bigger one. Okay, so make it bigger one. So if you want to add something, if you are not satisfied with this one and two, you want to mention it a word which is bus one, bus two. You just go to background and then text. Okay, click this and then text anything that you want, bus one or bus two. You will go here. For example, you want to put bus and okay. So you will see that there is a equivalent bus here, right? So you have bus number one, okay? And then go to background, then text, okay, text, then click this one. You have the bus because you want to mention about your bus so that you cannot forget that this is a bus number one and bus number two. Okay, is it clear? So actually, this is only additional information that I want you to show so that it is very easy for you to know where is the bus number one and bus number two. Then click this one, okay, for your nominal voltage. So nominal voltage, we need to change this to 132 kilovolt, okay? Then click OK. By the way, class, don't worry, because this is recorded. Anytime you can watch again this video presentation and then do it in your own, okay? So this is now with 32 kilovolt, and then click also this for the second bus. Okay, so change this also to 132 kilovolt. Then click OK. Then next, it is a generator. Click to network. All drawing should, you will find all drawing, it is in the network. Okay, then generator. So you need to put generator here. Okay, so in generator, you need to set up this to zero. Okay, zero. And then the orientation, you need to orient down, okay? Down orientation, and then click OK. So if you will notice, there is now a, the orientation now, it is in down mode here. Then in bus number 2, you will go to network again, and then you have the load. Okay, you have the load, and then click here about the load. The MW value should be 100. 100, and then display mode, this orientation should be also down, and then click OK. So as you notice, class, the generator and load, it is now in down orientation. Okay, next it is go to network. This is now again network, go to transmission line. So this is transmission line. In the connection of transmission line, you will click here once, then go up. Okay, one click, and then another one click here, going to right, and then, so as much as possible, make sure it is straight, then one click again, go down, and then if you are already here, double click. Okay, then after you double click it, so the requirement series resistance, as stated here, okay, as stated here, you need a 0.02 and then 0.02, okay? So you need to change it with 0.002, okay? And here, again, it is 0.002, okay? So, wait, it is wrong. Should be 0.002, okay? Then, click OK here. Okay, then next. The transmission line, so of course, as I told you before, all drawings should be in network. Now, we are looking for the equivalent answer. Where can we find the equivalent of this? The real power, reactive power, real power, reactive power in transmission line, apparent transmission line, power loss, bus 1, bus 2. All reading, you can find that in the field. So drawing already finished. This is now what we are going to do. We will perform it starting with 0.02, okay? 0.02 here. So we have 0.02, and then we will proceed it to our presentation. So this is now field, so we need a transmission line for the field. Take note that in the transmission line field, make sure that you are near in this generator, in this the transmission line near in the generator. You will click here, and then you will find this one, the flow of MW flow, okay? So you will put that near to this side, okay? Then, next, go again to field, transmission line, then click here. We need the reading also for M bar, okay? So, the MW, this MW, it means the real power. M bar, it is the reactive power. Okay, reactive power. Then, we will go again to field for the transmission field, for transmission line field. Click this and then click this line. It is near in the side. You will see the MVA flow, which is the apparent power. This is the apparent power. So, I repeat, this is the real power, this is the reactive power, and this is the apparent power. Click this apparent power, and then you can drag it also here. Then next, we need also the field. It is also in the form of field. So, because this is transmission line, all data we can find in the field. So this is field. Then again, the same in the transmission line field, and then click here in your load. Okay, click in your load, you can find the current ampere flow. Okay, click this and then okay. Okay, so this is now your current. Okay, then next you will go again to field, transmission line, and then click your load, and then you need the losses for real power losses. This real power losses, we don't need the losses for the apparent losses because the value of this is always zero. It is constant zero. So what we need is only the current and then the real power. So click OK. So we have already here the reading here. Okay. So now we will go to transmission line, then field. So we will go to field again, field, and then we will go to bus field. For what purpose? For our generator here should be near to this generator. Click near to this generator. Okay, then we need a bus voltage in kilovolt. This bus voltage in kilovolt. Click OK. So you have already this. So if it is small for you, you can make it bigger. Okay, you can make it bigger value. Okay, this one. The next, here also you need to click also here the field bus field should be near the load. So this is near load. What we need also, it is the bus voltage in kilovolt. So this is now the value. Okay, so make it bigger so that it is visible for you. Okay, the next, we have already the, this is already the generator, this is the transmission line, this is the load. We are looking for transmission line power at the receiving end. This is the experiment number one. And then we are looking for the value at 0.002. Then we will adjust it again, the value reading, okay, until we will comply with the other. So now, what is next? We will go to run mode. This is the run mode. And then next is tools. And then you will see this green button. Then play. Okay. So as you've noticed, there is now an equivalent reading here. Okay. You have the equivalent reading already here. So what you're going to do for you not to lose this reading, so of course in your computer or in your cell phone, mobile phone, you have the screenshot or snipping tool. But I would suggest for you to use the snipping tool. Okay, this is a snipping tool. It is a powerful. So click copy and then go to your report. Go to your report and then click here, results and discussion. Okay, right click, then paste. So if you will notice here, class, this is now my, okay, I will make it smaller so that you will see. about the results and discussion, because this is what you're going to do in the experiment, okay? Okay, like this. So immediately you can find out, you can find immediately what is stated here, okay? That the real power, it is 100. This is a real power, 100. Then zero for the m bar, this, okay? Zero m bar power, okay? Then the resistive, you have, it is already given, given resistive, and then at 0.2, and then next, it is the MW power, it is 100, okay? It is a 100, okay? Here, 100 for the transmission line, and then the power here, apparent power, MVA, how much MVA, 100, and then the current, how much current, you have this current in ampere, 438 ampere, okay? 438 ampere. Is it clear? And then losses, this one, losses, it is a zero. And then bus one, you have bus one, 132, okay? And then here, it is 131 for your bus 2 in your load, okay? So the required calculation and discussion after you come up with this drawing, after you will have the using the snipping tool, or you have to take it by your mobile phone by screenshot, we need a discussion, because this is already the result, okay? We have already the result here. And then what I need, it is the discussion. So it would be better if you will do it by your handwriting about your discussion and then calculation, because we have already the data here, okay? You have already the data here. So how would I know that you will perform this or not? Because I will give your marks as your performance. How would I know? The question is, how would I know that you will do the task? Okay, so I perform already row number one. This is row number one, and then this is my equivalent circuit. Okay, after you perform row number one, actually all of this, you need to perform all of this. Okay, you need to perform all of this. So next, it is to perform again next task. So row number two, row number three, row number four, I will assign to you individually. Okay, individually I will assign it to you, but I will show you how to perform it. In my drawing, if I will click two times, you will immediately go here. Series resistance and series reactance. What is the next in our table? In our table, we need 0.02 and then 0.04. Okay? So, from here, you need to, you have already here 0.02. Okay? I will show you here. 0.02, and then next is 0.04. The series reactance is 0.02, and the next is 0.04. Okay, next is 0.04, then okay. Only click okay, you have already the equivalent value here. So did you see? There is an equivalent value already here. So this equivalent value here, you need to take again this one, okay? Take snipping tool, okay, snipping tool. So I don't want to show because that is your task. Huh? So from here, okay. Okay, so snipping tool for your reading number 2 from here. So I will cut this for my table number 2. Okay, this is table number 2, for example. So here, copy, and then here in your report, for those who are belong to task number 2, you will only consider this. So this is now paste it here. Okay.